The Travels of Mr. Hulot.
Edgar says his tone's really different because he may have hit one of the knobs at some point. It's going to be louder now. I think I'll use that excuse sometime. This song is an adventure song, and we wrote this on our trip last year. We were in India, and we wrote it about this movie star guy in France. His name is Mr. Hulot, and he's a really stodgy character. That's the only French word in the whole show, too, by the way. And he's this stuffy fella who's got the perfect Citroen car and a little black pencil mustache and perfect patio furniture. So this is the adventures or the travels of Mr. Hulot, excuse me, for you French majors.
Thank you.
Thank you. Wow, that's like, that's gone. I was just at the Tennessee State Fair last night. That reminded me of some of the rides we went on out there. Scary business. That tune was called Big Coyote, and it's a fiddle tune from West Virginia, we believe. We're not absolutely sure, so we make up stories about it every night. It's a river in West Virginia. It's an Indian chief from North Dakota. It's a swamp in Missouri. It's a pine tree in Maine. I don't know. The next tune is a little ring going here. The next tune is one that Jerry wrote, and it's called From Ankara to Izmir. Another travel piece.
Consultant. We have a travel consultant, and his name is Steve Metcalf. Mr. Greenacres. And this is a trip, this is a song about taking a trip and only using airplanes.
Thank you.
Thank you. Now we're going to do a pretty song. This is one of Edgar's songs. This was on his first album. This was called Unfolding, when he and I were both on the MCA Master Series. And this song, Early Morning, followed a song called After Dark that had some sounds on it that Edgar doesn't make anymore. I asked him the other night to do whales, and he said he doesn't do whales anymore. And he doesn't do elephants either. Still don't? We need to renegotiate our contract, too. You don't do seagulls now, do you? Later. I'm going to wreck the mood. This is a very beautiful song. This is called Early Morning.
Thank you.
Thank you. You know, we play all over the country, and we were playing in Ann Arbor, Michigan one time, and I noticed some people were closing their eyes on that one. And we told people that they might like to close their eyes and just relax while we played the next song. They all closed their eyes. It was a little folk club, and they all closed their eyes, and we left. So, we're still here. Not an illusion. We're going to do one more song and take a little break. This is a song of Russ's called Through the Gates. Well, thank you all for coming out tonight, and we'll see you in a few minutes. A short break tonight. Thank you.
Thank you all very much. We'll be back in a little bit. Thank you. On the break, did you have a nice beverage?
Yeah,
I had one too. This is called the Big Bug Shuffle. Thank you. Russ was prompted to write that song as we were going through the India Museum in Calcutta. And we went through the mammal room and the reptile room, and then we went into the insect room, and they had these huge, big old things. Could chase it around. Chase one in your hotel room. You know, there's usually a lizard in your hotel room to take care of these bugs, but And some of these bugs, there was no lizard that could match some of these bugs. Maybe a Komodo dragon or something. But you hit it, you know, roll up the New York Times like Pete was talking like last night. And not actually exactly like he was talking. You roll it up and... That guy's twisted, isn't he? In his own peculiar way. And you hit one of these bugs with this newspaper and it would just laugh at you. We're going to do a song now that's called Push Too Far that Russ and I wrote for the International Note Contest out in Weezer, Idaho a couple years ago. And one of the rules was you had to have 25 notes in the first measure. And we tried really hard every day to write a song that would be that no one else could play. So after 3 days, we had this song that we couldn't play. So we had to like back up just a little bit and start over again. So we ended up with this song. It's called Push Too Far. It's one of Edgar's favorite songs in the world. I know it is. He told me. The other night, Russ counted this song off. We were somewhere in Russ. One, two, three, go.
We got it. Ready? Go.
Thank you.
Thank you. Now we'll play a fast one. We're gonna play a slow down a little bit actually for a second and play this song that Russ wrote a while back. It's on. Is this on Moving Pictures? Yes, Moving Pictures. Russ Barenberg's record, Moving Pictures, on Rounder Records. There's your plug. This is called Open Arms.
Berenberg on the guitar.
Well, we're going to leave you alone with Edgar for a few minutes, and you may never be the same. He's the only guy on the planet that plays like this, is Edgar Meyer.
Thank you.
It's a bass, Edgar.
Thank you.
Should I tell them what some of these songs are? Or should we just be snob musicians and play?
I'll talk to them.
Just play? We did, the big guitar tune was called The Earl of Hindford, and also had a song in it that Edgar wrote called Open the Present. What's that mean? Is that around Christmas or something? What's a birthday song? And then we played Peaceful Return. Has this little irritating part that keeps coming. That one. Taking notes from Irritating Return. And that was called Touch of the Hidalgo.
Yeah, I was hoping we could do that one that Russ wrote for the talk show host.
We're doing it now. It's not written for a talk show host.
He even called it for Jay Leno.
No, he didn't call it for Jay Leno. He called it for JL. It's for John Lennon. It's called for JL.
that we're going to play one more song. This is called the Emphysema Two-Step. Ripped it off of an old Cajun guy down in Louisiana. His was slower. He called it the Emphysema Waltz. And so I added more chords and play it faster. So it's called the Emphysema Two-Step. I want to thank Bill Bost for having us out here, Acoustic Stage, for having us down here. It's been fun. I've been here for two nights, and I'm not ready to go yet. I'm moving my house trailer here tomorrow. And you guys are going to live with me. Well, thanks for coming. Appreciate you coming out on a night like this. Is it still raining? Well, forget that then. Anyway, this is Russ Barenberg. It's Edgar Meyer. I'm Jerry Douglas. Thanks a lot. And we'll see you again sometime. Edgar got scared backstage, so we had to come back out. Those fluorescent lights, they don't do much for you, you know. Have those royals been in the news lately?
What?
The royals. The royal family.
Do a medley, a set, a brace of fiddle tunes.
Contra and Western.
These are contra dance tunes that I learned up in New England. What's so funny? New England. Ah! It's like Southern chauvinists, I get it. That's okay. It's nice down here, too. I used to play a lot of dance stuff. I know they've got a big scene like that in a lot of these towns down here. Knoxville is a lot of contra dancing. Anyway, the northern tunes have a sort of a slightly different flavor to them, and this is a set of three of them. The first one is called Lady Walpole's. Many of them are named for people, and there apparently was a person named Lady Walpole. And then Batchelder. Walpole was her last name.
Why?
Because it was her parents' name. They emigrated from Scotland and they couldn't.
Somebody
had to see a wall and a pole and a wall.
This is fascinating, isn't it? I think we better. Anyway, Lady Walpole's real, Batchelder's real, and this third one is called Macklemoyle's, and I think it has some other names. Macklemoyle. It sounds funny, doesn't it?
Yeah, I wouldn't name a tune Macklemoyle. What kind of name is that?
You don't have to, because there already is one.
Okay. We're just furthering the study of fictional anthropology. Yeah, that last tune was a Cajun tune. Thanks, Edgar. We have records for sale. We tune because we care.
We do. Well, why don't you come talk to us afterwards? We'll hang out by the record table, and we'd love to meet you. Anyone who cares to, I mean, you know, you probably don't want to meet us, but we want to meet you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you all. Good night.
If you want to hear the same tunes done in different keys tomorrow night, come to Green Acres down in Forest City. If you're out of town for the weekend, just drive on by.
How do you get there from here, Sam?
I don't know. Here's an instrumental we'll do for you. We'll jam a little bit for you here and tune off of Commonwealth. This is called Sapporo.
Bush on the mandolin. Thank you.
Bela Fleck. Pat Lynn on the guitar. John Cowan.
Thank you all.